Hi friends, in this video I show you how you can deploy a simple Spring Boot project on a render website. As an example, we try to create a math service which solve lead code problem expression add operators. This is the problem. So we try to create a service which solve this problem. So the final result will be like this. So here, if I change this to parameter num and target, I got the result here. Let's take a near look about the problem. So given a string num that contains only digits and an integer target, return all possibilities to insert the binary operators plus, subtraction and multiplication between the digits of num, so that the result expression evaluates to the target value. So as an example, here we have a num and target 6. So here, if I insert here multiplication, this give me 6, and the same thing here, 1 plus 2 plus 3 evaluates to 6. In the second example, we have 2 3 2 and target 8. So if I put here multiplication and addition, I got here 8, and the same thing here, I start by the plus sign and multiplication. And now here in the third example, there is no operation which give me this target. We try to focus into API rather than solving the problem. So here, if I take this example 2 3 2 and 8, by the way, I test the first example. So here the num 1 2 3 and the target 6, so this is the result. So let's try 2 3 2. 2 3 2 and the target 8. So this is the result. I will show you step by step how I create this API. If you are interested, stay with me. So here I create a project using Spring initializer, and also I need the package of the web service. So this is the package as we see in the dependency. Here we have a controller class. I put a get request into this path solution. So here I invoke the solution class and I call add operators function. So let's take a near look about a solution class add operator, and this type of problems classifies into hard problem. So as we see, hard. So now you need to build jar file by clicking into package, double click. So the build was finished. So let's take a look in the project. So this is the target folder. So this is the jar file. So we need also to create a Docker file. The Docker file contains this code. Here also you need to create a Git unit. So as we see here, so you need to install Git. So this is Git bash. I show you all the important step here. So create a jar file by building the project using Maven. Initialize repository in your Spring project Git unit. So here I open Git bash here and I initialize a Git here. So I put Git in it, open the Git ignore file in the project root and remove some references. So here, go here and I open Git. So you should delete So this, because here we need the target folder. So let's take a near look about remote repository. So this is the repository here. So as we see here, I need the target folder, because by default, when I upload this project into remote repository, so this folder will disappear. For that, I update git ignore and I delete this part. Create a Docker file with the following code. We will see it now. So this is the content of the Docker file, and push the project to GitHub. Create an account on Render and connect to your repository GitHub. So here I show you all the command. So I put git init. After that, I put git add. I stage all the files by git add space and point. Point means all the files, and git commit and git remote add origin. And here I put the URL of my remote repository. So this is the URL, and git push dash u origin main. So I push the local projects into remote repository. So this is the project, and this is the Docker file, and this is the target, and inside the target we have a jar folder. So now let's move into Render website. So Render cloud application hosting for developers. So you should to create an account and sign in. So go into new web service, and here you need to put the remote repository. So I copy this link and I pass it here. So let's try it with it. Connect. So here you need to choose a name, and here I choose free subscription and create web service. So in the end, so this is your URL. I wish this video will be helpful for you, and we will meet in other videos.